Good morning, folks. We've got news to discuss across the solar system with a focus on weather and climate today. We are zoom shifted southward here to see the filament near the South Pole, so let's begin at spaceweathernews.com, finding the last 24 hours on our star. Still no sunspots at the bright active region and no solar flares. We did take a bit of geospace fluctuation in the last few hours as plasma density of the solar wind doubled and then some. The extra pressure brought the KP index back up off the floor. Bit of aesthetics here. Back to the south so we can see the ionized helium view of those plasma filaments. Left side is a sparse prominence, but bottom right there is a thick rope that hugged the polar crown, but is beginning to lift this morning. 211 angstrom views up next. The majority of the large patch is merely thin coronal regions, but amidst that central dark area are indeed a few real small coronal holes. Dark spots also visible in the gold 193 angstrom view. Yesterday we mentioned the quake risk from Taiwan to Japan. This morning let's add the region in the South Indian Ocean taking an unusual foreshock uptick. Let's next go to the weather, find the focal point off the east coast of the United States. Twin systems spinning in the Atlantic are Chris and another low that was ripped out of a line of clouds on which Chris was spinning. What was a long tropospheric flow got confined to sister systems. We'll pull the lightning overlay to the front here so we can get the electrical vantage point next. Certainly noteworthy the daily explosion of flashes over land as well, far outweighing marine flashes in number every day. Meanwhile, Super Typhoon Maria is at the island chain connecting Taiwan and Japan. The system is a beast, and by tonight it will have hit them and made its way over to the coast of China. Zooming in on mesoscale views, we want to note the penumbral lines, the whistlers, defining the energetic boundary of this Earth spot. More on that Earth spot term below the video. We're heading now way, way out into deep space, where a cosmic jet has been imaged with some of the best precision yet. The goal in the future will be to see if they can measure expansion or rotation in subsequent observation missions, to attempt to learn more about the formation and evolution of the massive galaxies producing what we call quasars, the cosmic jets. Up next, we've got plasma waves sent from Saturn to Enceladus along the magnetic field connections between the two spheres. Again, feeling my lament at our lack of information on our moon's magnetic connection to Earth, but alas, this lets us reconsider the breadth of interaction between the Sun and planets as well, sort of a new way to think about flux transfer plasma events at Earth. Lastly, folks, U.S. Climate Report is out for June. Same thing here every month, regardless of where the overall average temperature falls. The minimum temperature is what's driving the heat. Maximum temperatures always show the least amount of heat, which signals a decreasingly extreme temperature profile, by the way. Lower overall maximum temperatures, not getting quite so cool at night. Basically, the temperatures every month show up as heading towards the middle from both sides. We greatly appreciate your support. Check out the links below the video and consider joining the website, getting one of our books, or getting the Disaster Prediction app, maybe even coming to our conference. We greatly appreciate your support. Info on all of those items momentarily, but we've got wind maps and shots of our star to close. Do this all again tomorrow, right here, but right now it's 4:35 a.m. in the new Valley of the Sun. Eyes open, no fear. Be safe, everyone.